Hello and very warm welcome to this Dhanteras special edition of Commodity Champions. I am Anisha Gupta. Buying gold during Dhanteras and Diwali is considered auspicious in Indian households. The yellow metal has been the best performing asset this year. This is the economic uncertainty brought by the COVID-19 which has forced investors to park their funds in safe haven assets like gold. Gold prices have jumped nearly 32% this calendar year. Despite the correction, domestic gold prices are still hovering around more than Rs 50,000 per 10 gram levels. And while there are various ways of buying gold, today it's all about Dhanteras buying. And joining me to take the discussion forward is Tomas Printer. He is Managing Director at the International Gemological Institute. P.R. Somasundaram is Managing Director of India at World Gold Council. Colin Shah is Chairman, the Gem and Jewelry Export Promotion Council. We also have with us Rajiv Popley, who's Director at Popley Group. Many thanks, gentlemen, for joining us on CNBC TV 18 today. And it has been quite a day and quite a year, all-time highs in case of gold prices. Som, let me come to you first. And, you know, there has been a report from World Gold Council telling us that this year we've seen the least gold buying in 25 years. But this quarter perhaps could manage much of those losses. What are the initial feedbacks? What are you hearing?
Certainly, it has improved over what we have seen in the last two quarters, which have been one of the lowest we have ever seen in our data series. Whether it would reach the levels we have seen in the last few years, quarter four, is still difficult to say. But clearly, things are looking up. And it looks like Dhanteras and Diwali will be a break from whatever challenges we have faced. So this could lead to a revival of consumer sentiment.
Well, that is clearly what the markets are hoping for as well, Som. But are there any initial trends? Is there a number that you're putting out yet? Because the second quarter, we saw 70% decline in demand for India. Third quarter was 30% down. Is there any initial trends for this quarter?
It's still difficult to say what would happen. India can actually surprise with a 200-ton buying in a single month. So it is it's still out there, and it's one of the most busiest seasons. We do hope that people come back to buy, but we haven't put any figures to this year yet, Manisha. We have left this year as one which is unpredictable, and therefore it's better not to give any kind of forecast.
All right, not yet, but we will come back to you, Som, before this year ends on what it looks like. But Colin, what's your sense? Because you have been talking numbers. You are somebody who talks a lot of numbers. So what is your sense? What is the buying looking like? What is the domestic demand? And you know what? When you talk about Dhanteras, it's not just the Indians in India buying gold, but you have similar kind of reports coming in from Canada, Singapore, Dubai, etc. on how Indians are stepping out and buying gold today.
So thanks, Manisha. Happy Dhanteras to you and all the viewers. In terms of numbers, when I speak to, say, most of our top retailers in India or globally, so just the month of October, in terms of value, they are more or less at the same level where they were in October last year. So if you take the gold price increase away, in terms of value, they are at the same level. In terms of volume, they are not at the same level. So they are happy that at least in terms of value, you know, they're at the same level where they were last year. So we see, and, you know, I've been saying this on your program too several times, that, you know, we'll end the year maybe 25-30% lower than last year. But October to March should pleasantly surprise us that there is some amount of revenge shopping happening in China, in the US, and even in India. If you look at the crowds, you know, and most of the malls across the country which have opened up, things seem to be coming back quite strongly.
Well, yes, if you can't find solace in volumes, then value-wise, absolutely, we are looking at higher numbers here. And, you know, I've had various financial experts on my show so many times in so many years, but this is the first time ever that most of them are advising to buy gold, add it into your portfolio in some sense or the other. So clearly, gold is mainstream, and why not? Because it's the best asset performing there. Rajiv, let me come to you. And while, of course, we've seen a lot of people thronging out, buying gold jewelry and gold coins and silver, etc., what's your sense when it comes to online buying as well? Because that trend really seems to be picking up, especially when people were sitting home during the lockdowns.
That's right. With the numbers, I'm totally with Colin. Numbers are coming back much better than what we expected. And it's also thanks to online, because it's just the communication gap which has been bridged. Fortunately, we were ready with the online technology part of it, and it helped us a lot, in fact. lockdown was only online for us because there's nothing offline. So it was more of connecting with our loyalty program customers, and they helped us, you know, pass the period with an online business itself. So online takes a lot of confidentiality on the transaction and at the same time trust factor. If these two things are handled perfectly, I think online for jewelry is the way to go now.
Yes, there are a lot of ways of buying gold, as we've discovered in this year. It can be digital, online, jewelry, and by the way of ETFs and bonds. So yes, the gold buying pretty much has been on there. Mr. Printer, let me come to you. And when it comes to buying gold, whether it's online or offline, it all has to be certified. And that is where exactly a firm like your comes in. People want to know that wherever they pick it from, whether they're buying the genuine thing or not. So what has been your experience during the lockdown? And now when the markets have opened, are people picking it up?
A very happy Dhanteras to you and all the viewers, Manisha. My experience of the lockdown has been a really educative one. It's been an educative one actually for all of us. During the lockdown, we've been together on a personal basis with the family, and we've realized the value of each member of the family. And at the same time, after the lockdown, we have come to work, and you know, we've seen a tremendous trust in the productivity. We had to use less resources and try and produce more. So what has happened is that over the last couple of months, and especially in October, can you believe, Manisha, I have registered the highest sale, highest revenue for the month, even better than last year, that is 2019. And we have been certifying gold jewelry, started with diamonds and gemstones. To a large extent, the Indian market has now, which has been silent for a few months, has now started buying. And you know, people are now buying because they recognize the importance of the loved ones, which they have shared the last few months with, which has never happened before in this century. And we've seen a growing trend in the export market. In fact, I reflect the sentiments of Colin, and I feel that, you know, in the coming months, especially now with the wedding season also coming in, a lot of buying, a lot of informed buying will be done, especially also on the online basis. A lot of small ticket jewelry is being bought, and all of that, which is generally IGI certified to authenticate the product online. See, when you buy online, you need some independent certification unit to authenticate the product that you're buying, the value for the money that you're paying. So IGI steps into that niche very well.
Oh, well, yes. You know, we had some viewers on our show as well some time back, and they said, my wife been cooking for me for the last 2 months now because of the lockdown. So I am definitely buying her some jewelry. So clearly that really has been the thing. But Rajiv, let me come to you. And I was talking to some other jewelers as well, and they said, if the way the buying has been going on, if it continues like that, then maybe 15 days from now, I wouldn't have enough stock to sell. Is that how the market is looking like?
That would be a very pleasure situation. We all would love to be in. I can book myself out for a holiday after that. I don't mind it. But that's a little hypothetical. As of now, we are pretty happy with the way numbers are turning out, especially for Dhanteras. Our numbers have been overwhelming. Dussehra was a start to show the season for us bang on. Going ahead, what's more important is the wedding season which follows, which is actually where the higher ticket value prices, you know, products are actually looked at. So that's really important, and that's where we want to sustain the numbers going ahead. So it's looking positive. It's pretty encouraging. And the whole idea that the country and the city, particularly Bombay, is opening up gives us a lot of confidence in the way we go ahead.
All right. Gentlemen, let's stop for a break. When we come back, we'll discuss with you on what are you buying on Dhanteras and also a piece of advice that you would want to give our viewers here. Coming back after that very short break. Well, festivities are all about buying and gifting gold, and that's exactly what we're discussing right now. So, Som, what have been the trends this year? While, of course, we've seen jewelry buying decline, and that might be recovering in this quarter, but the investment demand clearly has been on the higher side.
Yeah, ETFs, of course, Europe and US have led the way, 3,900 tons of the AUM as we speak, the highest ever. So that was known, but it is also bars and coins, even in India, China, and other consuming markets where jewelry was down. Bars and coins saw very, very steep growth. India itself saw a 49% growth. Although the base was small, quarter three was a 49% growth. It's got a lot to do with digital and, you know, people going and quickly picking up gold, but not having the time or wanting to lose the experience of buying jewelry, but buying gold instead. So we saw that, and we expect that that would continue even now, because at these prices, a bar or a coin comes probably with a lesser markup. So that also helps some people who don't need jewelry immediately. But eventually, all these get converted into jewelry. We expect bars and coins to be doing well, digital to do very well. Organized players, again, are much better placed this year. So they will actually have a much bigger share of the buying than in the past. So these are the trends we think will happen in quarter four.
Yeah. Colin, also, there have been reports on how rural India picked up faster than what urban did. And now that pent-up demand in urban India also is coming up. Are you looking at those trends going forward as well? And as per geographies, I mean, we do understand that South India tends to pick up the fastest, but how are the trends emerging from the rest of the country?
See, South continues to be strong, and it will stay strong because of their insatiable appetite, I guess, for gold, the yellow metal. Like, you know, in Kerala, the highest per capita consumption of gold in the world is in Kerala. But having said that, like further to what Som said, investment demand is coming back strong from rural areas across India. And over here, I'd just like to mention that even GJPC has made a series of 12 movies for all our retailers across the country and globally, where the message is simple: invest in gold, invest in your future. You know, what we realize is that a lot of retailers are not able to connect with millennials. They don't have access to nice agencies creating movies. So we have taken the initiative of doing that so that we're able to pass that message across the world and the country that investing in gold is, you know, investing in your future.
Okay.
And we've also made a series of movies for diamonds, where we are saying that diamonds are the ultimate gift of love. And whatever you gift this season, especially in this post-COVID world, diamonds are the ultimate gift of love, you know, in these troubled times where relationships, like one of the panelists said, mean so much. So what we are seeing is, you know, I guess a little bit of both happening, where gift giving will become diamonds and investing for returns will be gold.
Oh, well, so we yes. And I really hope that you all are walking that talk, because you're telling us to buy and hope you're also buying as well. So, Mr. Printer, when you said that this is going to be one of the better months for you, what is the ticket size that we are seeing? Are people still buying small ticket, or is there a lot of money spend happening?
See, there is a lot of buying of the small ticket sizes. Okay, that because, you know, we are certifying such a lot of jewelry, and quite a lot of jewelry is also lightweight jewelry because of the high prices of gold. Technology is being used to produce lightweight jewelry so that, you know, it can become more affordable. Another thing is, diamonds is a gift of love. And, you know everything about love, but you don't know anything about diamonds. So that's where IGI steps in. And we certify the diamonds for the consumer. And that way, he or she is assured that they are getting the value for the money that they spend. So we've seen in the month of October, a lot of stocking up happening. So we have been actually working 24/7, 7 days a week, all around the clock, and trying to certify as much as possible so that it can hit the shelves during the right time. And also I've seen a tremendous insurge in the US market. We certify a lot for exports, and we have, from the SIEB's office, we have big, huge retailer programs, which we keep certifying. IGI certifies worldwide, and it is accepted the worldwide over. So we've seen the October month as an excellent month.
All right. So we are cheers to that, really. And you said everybody knows about love and not diamonds. About love also, there's a bit of a question mark, but I'll let you go at that. That's a debate for another time. But gentlemen, thank you so much. We'll let you go at that. Wishing you a very happy Diwali, Dhanteras and the festivities. Hope you go ahead and buy that precious metal as well. But, you know, there's one person who is actually seen as the ambassador for gold, and that is Bappi Lahiri. He's known as the Disco King and the Gold King as well. And Bappi Da, a very happy Dhanteras and Diwali there. You are in your usual avatar, and this year we've seen gold at an all-time highs in India and the US and other 69 countries. We've seen gold touch a high of 56,000 rupees in India. What do you think? Should people continue to buy gold?
मैं एक ही क्वेश्चन बोलूंगा, आंसर बोलूंगा। गोल्ड मैं जब से पहनता हूँ, छोटे बच्चा से, 17-18 साल से मैंने गोल्ड एक चेन दिया था मेरे मम्मी ने, बाद में मिसेस लैरी चित्तन लैरी ने काफी चेन दिया, बिकॉज ऑफ माई लक, लकी। जैसे जैसे एक एक साल चला, इतना गोल्ड इज माई लक, कोई नया सोना लिया नहीं, ना सोना का भाव क्या होता है वो जानता भी नहीं, मैं खाली एक ही जानता हूँ, बस गोल्ड इज माय लकी। सोना हमेशा हमारा साथ रहे, जैसे देखिए सोना हमेशा रहता है साथ में, पर ये जो है गणपति बाबा मेरे लिए लकी है, सिद्धि विनायक उनका पूजा करके, बालाजी और मेरा गुरु सत्यनारायण, बस सभी गोल्ड में ही हैं। मैं एक ही चीज जानता हूँ, गोल्ड इज माय लकी। गोल्ड टच होने से बप्पी लहरी का भी गाना गोल्ड टच होता है, और डिस्को किंग जो बोलते हैं आपको, बिकॉज ऑफ माय गोल्ड, गोल्ड टच।
Gold is lucky for you, and gold is considered lucky if you buy it today. It may double going ahead, is what the Indians believe. Well, the value of gold has risen several times, and perhaps since you first bought gold. So, do you have any advice for our viewers?
एक बात सुनिए, किसी ने बहुत पहले बोला था, सब कुछ धोखा दे सकता है, gold कभी धोखा नहीं देगा। बहुत पहले जब मैंने सुना, धीरे-धीरे ऐसे चेन, मैं सोचा, लेकिन मेरा गुरुजी जो थे वो थे एल्विस प्रेस्ले। एल्विस प्रेस्ले का स्टाइल था मेरा जैसा, चश्मा, ब्रेसलेट, चेन, इतना चेन नहीं, एक चेन बड़ा मोटा। मैं सोचा था कभी ना कभी मैं बनूं कुछ, बापी लहरी बन के बॉम्बे में, तो आई विल ट्राई टू इमेज माय गोल्ड इमेज, भगवान का दया से इमेज हो गया, सब लोग जानते हैं बापी लहरी इमेज, gold, gold, bling, bling, Bappi Lahiri.
Bappida, we really appreciate you joining us on Dhanteras here with us for our viewers, but we definitely cannot let you go without a few songs. So on this festive occasion, what is that one song that you would want to sing for us?
यार बिना चैन कहाँ रे, चैन यार बिना चैन कहाँ रे, सोना नहीं चांदी नहीं यार तो मिला, अरे प्यार कर रे, सोना नहीं चांदी नहीं यार तो मिला, अरे प्यार कर रे।
And I remember, Bappi Da, last time I had met you, you'd sung a song only for me. So which one is that going to be this time?
आपके लिए मैं, तूने मारी एंट्री यार दिल में बजी घंटी यार, टन टन टन, ओ सोना ओ सोना, तुम्हार मुंडा दिए जाओ तारा तारी ऐसे जाओ, ओ सोना ओ सोना ओ सोना, तूने मारी एंट्री यार दिल में बजी घंटी यार, टन 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 टन। और आपका एक और सुनाता हूँ स्पेशली, चेहरे के हम तुझको लेके चूरे बड़ी बुम्बार, उलाला 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 उलाला, तू है मेरी फैंटेसी, उलाला 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 उलाला, तू है मेरी फैंटेसी या दिवाली मनाइए, खूब खुशी मनाइए, घर में आप लोग बहुत मिठाई खाइए, सबको मिठाई बांटिए और सोने का प्राइस बढ़ते रहिए बढ़ते रहिए। बापी दादा खुश है, बापी दादा खुश है।
Mapida, thank you so much for joining us. Very happy festivities to you as well. But with that, it's all the time that we have on this special edition of Commodity Champions. A very happy Dhanteras to all our viewers.